time. I don't even feel tired. Vivian.
Oh, Wheeler, I didn't know you were here.
How many times have I spoken to you and John about jogging in the house? Now, in the future, I'd appreciate it if you'd use the rear entrance. You both look like you took the wrong turn to the locker room. Locker room. How would this have looked if I'd been entertaining someone?
I'm sorry, Mrs. Wheeler. We didn't think.
Obviously.
In the future, we'll use the back door, Mrs. Wheeler.
Thank you, John. I'd appreciate that. See that you do. Now, Mr. Wheeler will not be home for dinner this evening.
You won't?
Strange. What's strange about it?
Well, usually Mr. Wheeler is very good about telling me when he won't be home for dinner.
I'm telling you, Vivian.
Yes, ma'am.
Where is he? I hardly think that's any of your concern.
Well, I was asking because I thought maybe I could keep something warm for Mr. Wheeler.
That won't be necessary. Mr. Wheeler won't be in any mood for dinner tonight.
Judy, this is Mr. Wheeler. Is Rena there? Oh, she's not. When did she leave? Oh. Did she say where she was going? I see. No. No, no message.
Hi, Dad.
Huh? Oh, hi, honey.
Something wrong?
Huh? No, not exactly.
What's that mean?
Oh, I got this note from Rena asking me to meet her in Dallas.
Dallas? You going?
You bet I am. Hello, John. This is Mr. Wheeler. I want you to come down to the office immediately and pick me up. Yeah. I want you to take me to the airport.
Well, Mr. Wheeler won't be coming home tonight.
You were right, Mrs. Wheeler. I've got to go take him to the airport.
Well, John, we don't want Mr. Wheeler missing his plane, do we? You better be on your way.
Ma'am, can I help you?
Yes, I'd like to check in, please.
Do you have a reservation?
Yes, I believe that room 2031C has been reserved.
Just a minute. Yes, here it is. Mr. and Mrs. Justin Marshall, right?
Yes.
Is Mr. Marshall with you?
No, he'll be joining me later. Thank
All
you.
All right, well then... Just sign right here, Mrs. Marshall.
The new generation. The first part of Texas is brought to you by the Comfortable Diaper. Loves disposable diapers.
Vivian, I'll be resting in my room. I hope your beef Wellington will be wonderful tonight. I seem to be developing quite an appetite.
Yes, ma'am. You look like you took a wrong turn into the locker room. That woman...
Hey, calm down, Vivian, calm down.
It's hard to keep calm when she says things like that.
Well, I thought you and Mrs. Wheeler were getting along better.
This Mrs. Wheeler is very difficult to get along with. Sometimes she's just fine, and sometimes she gets on her high horse again. I really don't understand her.
Yeah.
And there's something else I really don't understand.
What's that?
Why is Mrs. Wheeler having all these secret meetings with Ruby White?
I don't know, Vivian, but I really think you ought to stop worrying about it, and I think I better go pick up Mr. Wheeler.
Why would Mr. Wheeler want to go to the airport?
I don't know, Vivian. Maybe he was called away on a business trip. Well, maybe it came up unexpectedly.
I don't like it, John.
Like what, Vivian?
Just like that, on the spur of the moment, he wants you to take him to the airport?
That's right.
There is something strange in this house. And Mrs. Wheeler said...
Said Mr. Wheeler wouldn't be home for dinner. She was right.
How did she know he was going out of town?
I don't know, but I think I better go put on my uniform. Mr. Wheeler's waiting. I gotta go. I'll be back as soon as I can.
It just does not make sense to me that Mr. Wheeler wants to go to the airport like this. Drive carefully.
I will.
Do I look all right, Mom?
You look sharp.
Sure?
Yes, sir. You look just like I want my son to look. Well, except for maybe one thing.
What?
Yeah, come here. Let me straighten your tie a little. Okay. There. You are perfect. I love you. I love you so much.
I love you too, Ashley.
Oh, are you glad that the adoption's over with so quick?
Well, you bet I'm glad. I don't think I've been more happy in my whole life.
Me either.
Just wish Marshall could have been here.
Oh, well, he wanted to be here too. He hated missing this.
Why do you have to go out of town?
Well, he had business in Dallas. You do know that it had to be very important business for him to miss this, don't you?
Yeah, I guess so.
It's true.
Just thought that this celebration was for all of us.
Well, it is, but really it's just for you. Because it's your birthday. It's like a birthday party.
But it should be for all of us. I mean, Marshall's going to be my father, you're going to be my mother, and I'm going to be your son. It's a big thing for all of us.
You're right. I tell you what, when he gets back, just the three of us will have a big celebration all our own.
Oh, you mean it?
Sure I do. We'll go any place you want to go. What do you think?
Oh, it's going to be great. Oh, I'll get it.
Thank you.
Hi there, Gregory.
Hi, Paige. Hi, TJ.
Hi.
This is for you, buddy.
Oh, for me?
Yeah, and this one's for me.
Well, what are these for?
What do you think?
Well, we thought it was a pretty special day, and... I thought you deserve some gifts.
Can we come in, especially since we're bearing gifts?
Sure.
Why Dallas, do you suppose?
I don't know.
She just says in her note, meet me at a hotel in Dallas.
So what's the problem?
Well, there's no problem. It's just, it's puzzling.
Why?
Well, for one thing, I asked her to come to dinner with me tonight. And she said she couldn't because she had to be alone.
Alone?
Yeah. Of course, she hasn't been in a very good mood ever since Mark and I dressed her down for being involved with Hannibal.
Well, I'll tell you, Mark came down pretty hard on her.
Well, we both did. And with reason. You know, World Oil could have been compromised by what she did.
Rena had no way of knowing who Hannibal
was. Well, that's just the point. If she checked with us, then she should have, either Mark or me, before getting herself involved with him.
Well, look, if she had checked with you... Would you have known more about Hannibal at that point than she did?
Well, of course, because we would have checked him out before we let her go there.
Well, she made a mistake. She knows that. That's it.
What's what?
That's why she turned down your dinner invitation and she's setting up this rendezvous in Dallas. I bet that she's got something really special planned for you.
You think so?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, if she knew that you were upset with her, this is probably... an opportunity to get you away somewhere without interruptions.
Oh. How did you get to be so smart?
I'm your daughter.
Right, you are, aren't you? You sure are.
I'm so glad you're going, Dad. I think it's great. You know, she loves you an awful lot.
Well, I hope so, because I love her an awful lot. Go on, get out of here. Get out of here. I got a date in Dallas.
Vinegy Johnson. Sarah, this Cool Whip topping's been in the refrigerator a while. It's still fresh, isn't it?
Of course. Cool Whip's been improved to stay fresh even longer, so the last spoonful's as fresh as the first.
Delicious dessert. Topping tastes fresh.
Yeah, very fresh.
Well, fresh as your homemade.
Yep.
New improved Cool Whip stays fresher longer,
so the last spoonful's as fresh as the first.
It'll never work.
We're testing whether Tegrin can keep Lisa's dandruff under control for 3 days. Okay, Lisa, give it the Tegrin shape.
Looks terrific, but it's only 1 day.
Tegrin shape, day 2, Lisa.
Wow, Tegrin's on the job, but there's tomorrow.
Day 3. Let's see that Tegrin shake.
Hey, I'm really impressed. Tegrin, I'm sorry I doubted you.
Try Tegrin. It works.
Really works.
Between shampoos.
Hey, I just mowed 4,000 lawns. I don't have a sandwich appetite. I've got a manwich appetite. Yeah.
The winning team doesn't have a sandwich appetite. They've got a manwich appetite.
No skinny little sandwich makes as much of a meal as manwich. Your ground beef plus Hunt's manwich sauce. Thick with tomatoes, onions, peppers.
Honey, I don't have a sandwich appetite. I've got a manwich appetite.
A sandwich is a sandwich, but a manwich is a meal.
Alison Linden is now being played by Terry Gauber.
Stryker, I'm going out. Stryker?
Alison, I didn't hear you come downstairs. Where are you going, a birthday party?
Nope, better than that. Gregory's adoption became official today.
Wonderful, must be a happy boy.
Oh, he is. He was really looking forward to it.
He's a great kid. Not a bad pool player either.
Oh, he's pretty good at lots of things.
You tell me, let's have another pool game, drop over sometime.
Oh, I will.
Well, you better get going, ain't you?
Stryker, are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine, Alison.
It's not any of my business, but I know that you and Vicky have been having problems lately, especially since that picture of Vicky was in the papers with that man, but, have you been able to resolve anything?
No, but it's nice to have you concerned, but don't bother your pretty head. It'll work out.
I hope my staying here in this house hasn't caused any additional problems.
Of course not.
I just wish I could help.
Well, you can't, Vicky, and I'll work out the problem somehow. There is something you can do for me.
Oh, what's that?
Challenge me to a poker game again sometime.
Anytime you want, you just let me know. Playing you is money in the bank.
You're getting pretty confident there, aren't you, kid?
Sure am.
Well, you'd better get going. You don't want to keep Gregory waiting.
Right. See you later, Stryker.
Something? You are absolutely beautiful.
Oh, don't you always say that?
Do I?
Yes.
Well, I always mean it. I'm glad you came tonight.
How'd your business go this afternoon?
About as well as could be expected.
Well, it certainly looks good here.
Yeah? Too bad it's gonna have to end soon.
What do you mean?
Well, it looks like I'm going to have to relocate the place.
Then you know who the new owners are?
Yeah.
Well, have you talked to them? Aren't they willing to renegotiate your lease?
No, they are definitely not.
Why not?
They wouldn't discuss it.
I don't understand. Don't they realize they have a gold mine in this place?
Vicky, that doesn't make any difference to them. They are not going to renegotiate my lease. Believe me, they won't do it.
Hunt, we can't let this happen.
Don't you understand? There is nothing we can do.
There's got to be something. Who are these people? Hunt, look, I have very good contacts in real estate. Maybe I can use my influence and convince them to change their minds.
No, I don't want you to do that. Vicky, I want you to stay out of this. I do not want you getting involved.
Why not?
Because I am asking you not to. I'll handle this. Now give me your word that you'll stay out of it.
What's on the agenda, Mom?
Yeah. We are going to the Top of the World Club. We have reservations.
Top of the World?
Is there something wrong with that?
Well, I...
Do you not want to go there, Gregory?
Well, it's...
Well, look, I remember when I was a kid, the last thing in the world I wanted to do was to get dressed up and go to some fancy restaurant.
Well, is that the way you feel?
Well, the Top of the World's nice, but...
But it's not where you want to go. We can cancel the reservations.
Well, we do go to the Top of the World a lot.
Well, do you have a favorite place that you would like to go, Gregory?
Well, there is one place.
Yeah?
You name it.
Well, there's a hot dog stand near the park.
A hot dog stand?
Yeah, they've got great hot dogs. Marshall took me there all the time when you were in Savannah.
Oh, what are we waiting for? Come on.
All right, well, let's not all go. Let's set up for the party.
We'll stay here.
Well, Gregory and I are going to go and get the hot dogs, and we'll bring them back.
All right.
Is it all right, Mom?
Well, sure. In fact, it sounds real fun.
You ready to go?
Yep.
Okay. Wait a minute now. Are we really going to go to a hot dog stand dressed like that?
Nah, lose the jacket.
Yeah, okay, I'll go with my jacket. Come on, get the tie off. Come on, get rid of it.
Forget what I said about it.
Loosen up the tie, Mom.
Right?
Huh? Come on.
Look at those.
How did you tie this thing? All right. Come on, get that jacket off.
Oh, that looks...
There. Feel better?
Yep.
Okay, let's go, partner.
Whoa,
okay,
be careful.
Okay, guys, have a good time now.
Okay.
Be careful.
Bye-bye.
Happy trails.
Bye.
Yes, sir.
They made it. I can't believe it.
Oh, they are such a pair.
Yeah,
they sure are.
You know, TJ told me that he wants to sound exactly like Gregory someday.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
My name is Justin Marshall. Has my wife arrived yet?
Oh, yes, sir. In fact, you just missed her. She should be on the way up toward the room right now.
Very good. Is that room 2031C?
That's right.
Wonderful. Very good. Listen, this is a very special evening for my wife and me. I'd like dinner served in the room. A couple of Chateaubriands, a bottle of your fine, fine red wine. You choose. And, of course, some of your best champagne.
Yes, sir.
You tell that chef of yours to outdo himself. Or herself.
I certainly will. When would you like it served?
Give us a little while. Give us about an hour.
Yes, sir. You enjoy your stay in Dallas now.
I intend on doing just that. Bye. Well, hello there, pretty lady. What kind of flowers you got here for me?
Just about everything, sir.
They're beautiful. Let me have some of these. Oh, I love these. How about these two right down here, too? And, oh, these are great. I always love these. Beautiful. Oh, it's my favorite.
Chocolate sauce, soaked in motor oil, seeping, cola soil, grounding. Unless you clean the dirt to go all the way through, your whole wash isn't clean. That's why we invented Era. Era has the power of cleaners for deep down dirt, for soaked in grease, for seeped in oil, for grounding collar soil. Penetrating cleaners concentrated to put more cleaning power on the stain. Watch Era clean all the way through these three layers of tough stains. Put a teaspoon of Era only on the top. Its power penetrates. Rub, run under warm water, and look. Era cleaned all the way through. And when you get the tough stains clean, your whole wash is clean. Era cleans all the way through.
Let's face it, if all we had to clean was one little spot of greasy dirt, any cleaner full strength would do. But greasy dirt gets everywhere. So I clean by the bucket with Top Chop. It's a fact. No leading liquid in a bucket tops Top Chop on the toughest greasy dirt. Take pine oils. They're fine full strength. But pour them in water like I do. And see, Top Job cleans the toughest greasy dirt better than pines. Like they say, oil and water just don't mix. Yet toughest Top Job is, it's safe on my no-wax floor. So when you clean the toughest greasy dirt by the bucket, switch from pines
It's a top job. Its cleaning power holds up better underwater.
Come on in.
How you doing?
I'm all right. You look pretty.
Thank you. I have a present for your new son, Gregory. My new son, I can't get used to that. Put it with the other presents. Have a seat.
Well, where is everybody? I thought it was late.
Oh, you are. Don't worry. Paige is in the bedroom fixing her makeup, and TJ and Gregory have gone to get some hot dogs.
Hot dogs? I thought we were going to the top of the World Club.
That was the original plan.
Well, what happened?
Well, it ends up that Gregory's favorite restaurant is the hot dog stand down the street, right?
Sounds like Gregory.
I know.
Oh, Ashley, you look so happy.
I am. Allison, for the first time in a very long time, I feel like everything I ever dreamed of may come true.
Well, you don't have to worry about Hannibal anymore.
Yeah, thank goodness. I'm real glad that you're here. And Gregory was so excited when he found out you were going to get to come. It means a lot to him. To me, too.
Well, I wouldn't miss this for anything.
So how many should we buy?
Well, girls won't eat very much. Probably only two or three.
You can eat more than two or three hot dogs?
Sure. I ate seven once.
Seven?
Yeah, except I got a little sick. So I guess that doesn't really count.
No, I guess not.
Four sounds about right.
Okay, so that's two for each of the ladies and four apiece for each of us, right?
That's 14.
14.
Right. Come on there.
Howdy. My little pirate here says you got the best hot dogs in all of Houston.
Your son's absolutely right about that.
Oh, I'm not his son. See, I'm Justin Marshall's son. He's president of Marshall Oil. You well, remember him.
Any kind of luck, I just may be his uncle someday soon, though.
Is that a fact?
Yeah.
Well, what'd you like?
14 hot dogs for the works.
14?
Yeah, well, that's what we figured, right? 14?
Right.
Yeah, 14.
Right. Okay, coming up.
TJ, can we make it 18?
18? What?
Well, I wanted to save some for Marshall. I mean, for my dad.
Yeah, good idea. Little pirate here just changed his mind. He wants to make that 18.
All right. 18 of the finest coming up.
All right.
You a little bet. Your production division against mine. If I put you out of business in the next 6 months, we'll meet again. Right here. And you'll go to bed with me right in this hotel room.
What if I win?
I'll sell out Marshall Oil and leave Texas.
You're a liar.
No. I'm just sure of myself. Do we have a bet?
You've got a bet.
Justin Marshall, I'm finally going to nail you.
Just as I remember. Same as 6 months ago. Oh, I've been looking forward to this for a long time. Rena, you are beautiful.
Why, thank you, Justin.
These flowers for you.
Thank you again. They're lovely.
I've been looking forward to this for 6 long months.
So have I, Justin. You don't know how much.
You're riding in the sun all day. Refreshment seems a mile away. Now you're heading for home and your long day is through. There's something big waiting for you.
Now that our family's grown,
the Queen, Tom Brokaw will report.
There's a lot of agreement. High technology means jobs in the future. So let's stop kidding ourselves.
Brands like RCA, Whirlpool, and Sansui call America's largest call color time.
Stay tuned for the next part of Texas.
Heavy fighting in the Mideast, the latest in 12. Back now, the next part of Texas.
Vivian, I'm back.
You drive Mr. Wheeler to the airport?
Yes.
You talk to him on the way?
A little.
Did he tell you where he was going?
No.
Oh. John, what are you sitting there reading like that for? If Mrs. Wheeler comes down and finds you, she'll have your hide.
It's all right, Vivian. Mrs. Wheeler said she was going to stay up in a room until dinner was ready.
I know what she said. But you know she has a tendency to turn up when you least expect her.
Vivian, please don't worry.
She does have a tendency to appear unexpectedly, and we get into trouble.
I don't think she will this time.
Well, I hope not, for your sake. What are you reading? That's so fascinating.
It's this article. I would like to read it to you.
What is it?
It's a very poignant letter in the Advice to the Lovelorn column.
The Advice to the Lovelorn column?
Yeah.
I wouldn't have thought you'd read something like that.
What sort of thing do you think I read?
I don't know. Say, weather charts or the stock market report, stuff like that. That stuff's way over my head. Can't make heads or tails out of it, but you're very smart, John. I would have thought you'd been more interested in that stuff.
I'm also interested in the human condition, Vivian, and that's what these columns are all about. Would you like to hear it?
Of course.
Dear Miss Cynthia, I've known this woman at work for some time now. She's a very nice, very warm human being. She always makes me feel very special.
I don't see any problem there.
It goes on.
Oh.
The problem is, he's getting to the problem now. The problem is, I don't know how to tell her how I feel about her. I mean, what if I say I really like her, and she says she was just being polite? I know that if I don't tell her how I feel, our relationship will never grow. But if she rejects me, then I've jeopardized the relationship we have now. What should I do? Vivian?
You're right, John. That's a very poignant letter. It's really terrible when two people care so very much about each other and then they're too shy to tell each other how they really feel. I think he ought to just take the chance and tell her how he really feels. I think he ought to come right out and say, I really like you, and I'd like to get to know you better.
I really like you, and I'd like to get to know you better.
That's what I just said, John.
No, Vivian. That's how I feel about you.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Hunt, why are you being so stubborn about my not helping you?
It's just the way I want it.
Please, Hunt, let me help you.
Vicki, I appreciate the offer, I really do. But I have my reasons, and I don't want you getting involved.
All right. If you don't want me involved, I'll stay out of it.
Thanks, Vicki. So, how are things on the home front?
Stryker, nothing's changed. It's about the same.
I'm sorry that he's putting you through this pain.
No, Hunt, I'm beyond pain at this point. All I feel now is anger. Stryker will never be able to hurt me again.
Well, I feel bad that you've had to go through all this. I want you to know that.
I do.
Vicki, you and I are lonely people. Lonely people who have been hurt. And I know that it's hard to make a commitment when you've been hurt. And I'm not one to be preaching this. But you cannot bury your feelings in order to avoid being hurt.
I know that intellectually, but it's not always easy to remember emotionally.
I want to help you. I mean, you single-handedly helped me care about someone again. I want to protect you from being hurt.
Please, Hunt, be patient with me. I know... maybe it seems I'm keeping my feelings locked inside, but believe me, I've revealed more of my feelings to you than I have to almost anyone else.
It's a start, Vicki. It's a real strong start.
Oh, Miss Britt, don't go upstairs right away because your mom wants to see you right away.
Oh, thanks, Vivian. Listen, tell my mother that I have to see...
Britt! Oh, good, you're home.
Hi, Mom. That's all, Vivian, please.
Yes, ma'am. Could I talk to you, dear?
What about?
Why don't you join me for dinner?
I'm sorry, but Ricky and I already have plans tonight.
Oh, some other time, then. I'm glad you're going to see Ricky. Such a nice young man.
If that's all you wanted to say, Mom, I have to go and change. Oh, listen, Dad's not going to be home for dinner. He's on his way to Dallas.
Yes, I know.
You know? Well, he told me to tell you. Did he call you himself?
No, he didn't. I just know that he's gone to Dallas to see Rena Decker.
How'd you know that?
Darling, come and sit down for a minute. There's something I have to tell you.
Mom, what's going on?
I know you're going to find this difficult to believe, but Rena didn't go to Dallas to see your father.
What are you talking about? Of course she did. She left him a note. I saw it.
No, Brett. I sent that note.
You?
Yes.
I don't understand.
I found out that Rena had a bet with Justin Marshall. And if she lost the bet, which she did, she was supposed to meet him in Dallas and go to bed with him.
What?
I know. It's hard to believe.
It's not true. Rena can't stand Justin Marshall.
I'm sorry, it is true, Brett.
How'd you find this out?
Honey, that's not important. What really matters is that your father find out what kind of a woman Rena Decker really is.
I don't believe a word of this. Mother, how could you forge that note? How could you do that?
I had to, babe.
You had to? You keep saying you love Dad.
I do love your father.
Well, if you love him, how could you send him to Dallas like that? Especially if what you said is true.
I had to. There was nothing else I could do.
Do you know what that would do to him? Do you know how much that would hurt him?
Yes, I know. I know it's going to hurt your father, and I hate doing that. But don't you see? I had to do it because I love him.
Perfect. Now drive carefully.
I need a break.
Orange juice from Florida just can't be beat. 100%
pure orange juice from Florida. Isn't just the breakfast anymore. This boy is known as Little Mess because mishaps seem to follow him everywhere. So rather than drag out a heavy vacuum, his mother reached for her cordless dustbuster from Black & Decker. It's light, powerful, recharges continuously, and perfect for small, fast cleanups on stairs, floors, anywhere. So if you've got a little mess around your house, get yourself a Black & Decker dustbuster. When America has a job to do, it reaches for a Black & Decker.
Herman Lay didn't please every farmer he met.
Herman, I say it. A potato is a potato.
And?
I say, mine weren't firm enough.
Well, he's a picky man.
Likes a tasty chip, though.
Then Herman Lay set out to breed better potatoes.
Very foolish.
He's a picky man.
Likes a tasty chip, though.
Today, Lay's is America's best-selling potato chip. Herman Lay knows why.
We start with great potatoes.
Lay's, grown to be America's favorite.
The summer sizzles on NBC, sizzles with surprises on The Doctors.
Billy Aldrich and I are going to be married very soon.
Will Lola ever see her wedding day?
I still don't believe that Billy is the father of your child. You are not going to marry Billy.
This week on The Doctors.
Well, I think you're right, Gregory.
About what?
Green hot dogs are the best in Houston.
Uh-huh.
Although, I do know of another place that has hot dogs that are almost as good as these.
Oh, yeah?
Where?
The Astrodome.
No
hot
problem.
Dogs. Oh. Hot dogs they serve there are terrific.
You want to open your presents?
Thought you'd never.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Well, go on, Gregory.
I don't know which one to open.
Right here. Okay, let me help you. Take this one first.
Oh, who's that?
All right. Come on, rip it open.
Oh, boy. Dad,
whoa,
Gregory.
Look at that.
My.
Oh, wow.
That's for the new house.
Well, thanks, TJ.
Look, when you move in and get your hoop up, I'll come over and challenge it a little one-on-one.
You any good?
Pretty fair. The team I played on college made it to the semifinals of the NCAA championships.
Ooh, well, it must have been pretty good to play on a team like that.
Yes, and if you let him, Gregory, he will even show you all of his clippings. Great fun.
I'm a little rusty, but I am taller than you are, so I might be able to give you a good game.
Open mine next, honey.
Okay.
It's right there, the silver one.
Let's hold on, TJ. You didn't mind ripping into it,
didn't I rap that well?
Let's see.
Oh, wow!
Oh, what do you think, Gregory?
You like it, honey?
Oh, it's great!
Oh,
I'm
so
it's gonna look fantastic when Marshall and me race the Gregory one.
It's gonna look fantastic when you and Marshall watch the Gregory run.
No.
Race run.
It's gonna be much better in the car.
Sound just like Justin.
Like fire, like sun.
Here, Gregory, open up mine.
That's great for Marshall. It is. How'd you know what size?
Come on, boy, tear into that.
Into it. It's just like Christmas. Doesn't know what to think. He's gonna expect this every day. What is it? Hmm?
Come on, this suspense is killing.
Are you gonna tell
me? $1,000,000. What is it?
The $10 gift certificate to the ice cream shop.
Oh, oh.
All the banana splits to your heart's content. Well, that is as long as I don't have to eat as many as he does.
Well, no, wait a minute. What is this all about?
It's a private joke.
Well, we have one more here. This is from your mom and dad. Although I think you'll probably be able to figure out who picked it out. You're not going to believe it. I can't believe that we found it.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Look at that. Oh, Gregory won.
All right.
You like that? Oh, you're welcome. Sit in here. Oh, it looks good on you, too.
You know, I have a feeling you're going to have a hard time getting him to take that thing off.
Yeah.
What do you want to bet he goes to bed with it?
Yeah, I probably will.
I knew you were protesting too much, Rena. You're looking forward to this evening as much as I was.
Well, you know what they say, Justin. Nothing's worthwhile if it comes too easily.
Well, now, you just might have something there. Like the flowers?
You're such a romantic.
I got quite an evening planned for us, Serena.
Oh?
Champagne, Chateaubriand, fine wine.
I was kind of hoping that we could get right down to business.
Well, you really have been looking forward to this, haven't you?
Uh-huh. I didn't think that we came all the way to Dallas just to have dinner and talk. Did you?
Oh, certainly not.
I've been looking forward to this night for a long time.
Not much of a selection, is there?
A man was in earlier, nearly bought me out.
Well, may I have those, please?
You really are something, man.
What do you mean?
You're quite an actress. All that fighting and scratching in Houston, that was all an act.
It was for your benefit, darling. I know you well enough to know that you don't like a passive little mouse.
That's right. I like a woman with spirit.
Do I have enough spirit for you?
You sure do.
Justin. Oh. I sure hope that you're not dreading the terrible mistake you've made.
Mistake you talking about?
Leaving Ashley alone with TJ in Houston.
What are you talking about, Raina?
Well, darling, I'm just surprised that you trust him alone, that's all. I mean, after all they've been through. Didn't you know?
Know what? What are you talking about?
Well, sweetheart, Ashley and TJ were engaged in college. They were lovers. They were going to be married, Justin. Didn't you know that? Don't you wonder what they're doing right this minute?
Hey, thought you were brushing your teeth.
I was just thinking.
About what?
About Teddy. He always wins.
Well, your brother's a lot older than you are.
He'll always be older than me.
I know how you could beat him right now.
How?
Come on. You could get even fewer cavities than Teddy, because he didn't have this crust at your age. Advanced formula crust has Floracet.
So?
So it's even tougher than the crust your brother had, or your mother had, or I had. When it comes to checkups, you could beat us all.
Yeah.
Yeah. So maybe it's not so bad being the youngest after all, huh? With advanced formula crust, your kids could have even fewer cavities than you did.
I know every father thinks his daughter's pretty, and I'm no exception. My daughter Betty is a real ivory girl.
Meet Betty Ford, an ivory girl with healthy-looking skin.
I've used ivory all my life, even through my teenage years, when I had to keep my skin really clean, and it helped. Ivory's a basic natural soap. I don't like to use a soap that leaves heavy perfume or deodorant on my face. I want a soap that's natural and cleans, and that's ivory. That plus eating right and exercise really helps my skin stay healthy looking.
I'm really proud of Betty.
Healthy looking skin. Ivory can help you have it too.
My father can tell you, I've used ivory since I was a baby, and I'm really glad.
Vicki!
Yes, Jack.
Getting home kind of late, aren't you?
Not particularly.
Where you been?
I've been with Hunt Weston at the Starlight Lounge. He's having some difficulties, and I'm trying to help him out.
What kind of difficulties?
I've already explained that to you, Stryker. Someone new has bought the building, and they're not willing to renegotiate his new lease. It's not going to be easy for him to relocate.
Reese say anything else?
Stryker, I really don't think that's any of your business. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm going upstairs to change.
Hunt, Weston speaking.
Weston, this is Stryker Bellman. What the hell do you think you're doing?
What are you talking about, Stryker?
You told Dickie I bought that building.
I didn't tell her anything. I said I wouldn't.
What kind of game are you playing?
I'm not playing a game, but I think you are.
What's that supposed to mean?
Just what I said. I think you're playing games with your wife.
And look, I'm going to do everything in my power to see that she doesn't get hurt again. You just see that you do the same.
Ashley and TJ engaged.
That's right. What's so amusing?
You are? I know exactly what you're trying to do, Rena.
You do?
You think if I believe that absurd story about TJ and Ashley, I'll call off the bet. Well, it's not going to work. There never was an engagement.
Justin, you can verify what I told you just by talking to TJ's mother. Or any of Ashley's sorority sisters, for that matter.
Bernie, you're lying.
If that's what you want to think, darling. I gotta tell you, there are a lot of people that know about your wife's relationship with TJ. In fact, their love affair was the talk of the campus.
I don't want to hear any more of this.
Why not? Are you afraid of hearing something about your darling wife that happens to be common knowledge?
You've had it in for Ashley for a long time now. I think this is a pretty underhanded way to get out of a little bet.
I am being perfectly honest with you, Justin. More honest than Ashley has ever been. She does have a reputation for lying, doesn't she? She lied to you about being pregnant. So, you married her. Doesn't it make you wonder, Justin? Doesn't it make you wonder what else she's lied about?
I don't believe this, Rena.
Because you don't want to believe it. Think about it, Justin. Who was the one that insisted TJ work for Marshall Oil? Ashley wasn't. They spent an awful lot of time together.
You don't know what you're talking about.
Well, I don't know what you think, but it's pretty obvious to me. They were lovers once, and talk has it that they're lovers now. I mean, I don't know why you know, don't know that. I'm not the only one in Houston that knows that.
You stop it, Rena. That's enough.
Poor Justin. Poor, blind, foolish Justin.
Damn, stop it, Rena. I said stop it.
You are wrong about Rena. No, Brett, I'm not wrong. I know exactly what kind of a woman she is. And it's important that your father find out before it's too late. I don't believe you. You must be distorting something. No, Brett, I'm not distorting anything. I've told you the truth. Now, I know that you think that what I've done is cruel. I don't mean to be. I love your father.
Oh, what a way to show it.
Listen to me, Brett. I know this is hurting you because you're a friend of Rena's, but don't you see? She's fooled you completely, just the way she's fooled your father.
You are lying!
Brett!
You've been up to something ever since you came to Houston. Well, I've watched you hurt him before, and I'm not going to watch you hurt him again. Rena couldn't be with Justin Marshall.
Yes, Brett. She is. All right, I'm going to call her hotel room. And I'm going to talk to Dad if he's there. And I'm going to prove you wrong.
Stay tuned. Texas will be right back.
Since 1932, the one and only original Fritos brand
America's favorite corn chip. Muncha, 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 munch. Muncha, muncha, Fritos, go and lunch. For 50 years, Fritos brand corn chips. They wouldn't have lasted so long if they didn't munch so good.
Camera! Check! Cassette recorder?
Check!
Flashlight?
Check!
What about batteries? Last vacation, they wore out so fast.
Harry, I switched to Duracell batteries. They last longer. In fact, Duracell batteries last 3, 4, up to 5 times longer than regular carbon batteries.
Well, I'm convinced. Let's get going.
Check.
Duracell. The copper top battery. No regular battery looks like it.
Or lasts like it.
Diane Brock, don't treat your puppy like a dog. Hey, Steve Levitt. You're treating your puppy like a dog. Kit Miller, are you treating your puppy like a dog?
Oh, no. Dog food is for dogs. My puppy gets puppy food. Puppy Chow brand puppy food. I know puppies need more nutrition, and Purina Puppy Chow has it.
Good for you, Kit Miller.
No, good for him.
Don't treat your puppy like a dog, dog, dog.
No, no, no.
Give him Puppy Chow.
What's wrong, Justin? Aren't you in the mood anymore? You still want to go through with our bet, don't you? Don't think about TJ and Ashley. Hey, you're not reneging on our bet, now, are you? That must be our wonderful champagne dinner. That's so thoughtful of you, darling. We're going to have a wonderful evening.
Grant. Rena. Some guy bought up all the flour.
Not long ago, my only exercise was climbing up and down a stepladder. Today, I'm climbing Eagle Mountain. Boy, have I changed my life for the better. Back then, antique stores were the only place I knew to buy antiques. Now I know what to look for. I get my best buys at yard sales. That's some change. And before I knew better, I had to buy boxes of this and bottles of that to get my laundry clean and soft. But Bold Free Detergent Plus Fabric Softener changed that. Uh-huh, a product that cleans, softens, and controls static cling all in one box. Now that's a change for the better. Oh, I know, only if it works. Well, Bold Free works. Look at these jeans. Muddy, right? These were just as muddy. Would you ask more from a detergent? And talk about softness. I mean, this feels really soft. Now watch. No sticking, no crackling, no annoying static cling. Would you ask more from your fabric softener? Now that's some change.
A change for the better. Bold 3.
Where's the fire, boys?
Hey, just a practice run, Rosie. Oops.
Now what do you guys wear raincoats?
Oh, get something quick.
Relax. Bounty starts quicker.
Wow.
So you finish quicker.
Quicker than other towels?
Yep. Watch. A top challenger against Bounty.
Hey, Bounty starts working a lot quicker.
Right. Bounty starts quicker.
So, you finish quicker.
You bet your suspenders.
Ouch.
Bounty's the quicker picker-upper. Starts quicker, so you finish quicker.
This part of Texas was brought to you by Bounty, the quicker picker-upper. Join us each weekday at this time for the continuing story of Texas, the new generation. Monday night.
Sizzles on NBC. Sizzles with secrets on Texas.
I was kind of hoping that we could get right down to business.
Rena tells Justin about his wife's affair.
You still want to go through with our bet, don't you? Don't think about TJ and Ashley.
But Rena's revenge backfires this week on Texas.
The more I like you, the least excuse me for saying.
Hello.
Hey, Charlie, how are you?
Just great. Listen, can I get back to you, please?
Dynasty, Thursdays at 10 on CKCO-TV.
You again. They're lovely.
I've been looking forward to this for 6 long months.
So vibrant. You don't know how much.
Could I talk to you, dear? What about? Why don't you join me for dinner? I'm sorry, but Rick and I already have plans tonight. Some other time, then. I'm glad you're going to see Ricky. Such a nice young man. That's all you wanted to say, Mom. I have to go and change. Oh, listen, Dad's not going to be home for dinner. He's on his way to Dallas.
Yes, I know.
You know?
Well, he told me to tell you.
Did he call you himself?
No, he didn't. I just know that he's gone to Dallas to see Rena Decker.
How'd you know that?
Darling, come and sit down for a minute. There's something I have to tell you.
Mom, what's going on?
I know you're going to find this difficult to believe, but Rena didn't go to Dallas to see your father.
What are you talking about? Of course she did. She left him a note. I saw.
No, Brett. I sent that note.
You?
Yes. I don't understand. I found out that Rena had a bet with Justin Marshall. And if she lost the bet, which she did, she was supposed to meet him in Dallas and go to bed with him.
What?
I know. It's hard to believe.
It's not true. Rena can't stand Justin Marshall.
Sorry, it is true.
How'd you find this out?
Honey, that's not important. What really matters is that your father find out what kind of a woman Rena Decker really is.
I don't believe a word of this.
Mother, how could you forge that note? How could you do that?
I had to.
You had to. You keep saying you love Dad.
I do love your father.
Well, if you love him, how could you send him to Dallas like that? Especially if what you said is true.
I had to. There was nothing else I could do.
Do you know what that would do to him? Do you know how much that would hurt him?
Yes, I know it's going to hurt your father, and I hate doing that, but don't you see? I had to do it because I love him.
And now, the continuing story of Texas.
Well,
I wish the daughters had to run.
Oh, we really do, sweetie.
Thanks for the racing jacket and the basketball, Aunt Paige and Uncle TJ.
That is almost Uncle.
Well, when are you getting married?
Gregory.
Well, I don't know. I guess you're going to have to...
Have to ask your old Aunt Paige that.
Old Aunt Paige. I think that's our cue to leave.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Gregory, I want to thank you for letting us share your special evening.
Do you have to go already?
Yeah, honey, it's getting kind of late.
And I know somebody's going to have to hit the hay real soon.
Who? You getting tired already?
Smarty, get out of here. Eat us quick.
We'll see you soon there, partner. You take care of yourself. Don't go burning up the pavement in that outfit, all right?
I think that Ashley's going to have to hide the car keys. You're probably right.
Thank you. It was lovely.
Come on, thank you.
And thank you, nephew.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Thanks a lot.
You're welcome.
Well, my son, how did you like your party?
It was neat.
Oh, especially with all those gifts, huh?
But there was just one thing wrong.
What's that?
My dad wasn't here.
You were thinking about him a lot tonight, weren't you?
Every single minute. Wonder if he thought about me, too.
Oh, sure he did.
Yeah?
Of course. I'll bet you that he's sitting in his hotel room right now wishing that he was here with us. Yes, could you please ring Mrs. Decker's room? Rena Decker. D-E-K-K-E-R. You don't? You sure?
Ask for Justin Marshall's suite.
Do you by chance have a Justin Marshall registered there? Mr. and Mrs. Marshall. No, thank you. Yes. Yeah, ring Mr. Marshall's room for me.
Grant, what are you doing here?
You invited me.
What?
I'd like to know why.
You got a lot of little tricks up your sleeve, don't you, lady? You're going to pay for this one. Don't you think you're going to get away with this?
Grant, I want to...
Rena, just what in the hell is going on here?
Texas, the new generation. The first part of Texas is brought to you by Coast Soap, the refreshing soap that brings you back to life. Coast Deodorant Soap, the eye-opener.
Grant. I know what you're thinking right now.
Do you? Why did you send me that note?
Please listen to me, Grant.
Answer your phone.
Grant, I want you to understand.
I'll bet.
What note?
The note you left me in my... This is monstrous. What kind of a cruel, stupid game are you playing?
I never meant to be cruel, but you've got to understand that this has nothing to do with us.
That's the most outrageous statement I have ever heard in my life. You... Will you stop playing this game?
I'm not playing games. I don't know anything about a note.
Rena, I'll play your game. You sent me a note. You asked me to meet you here in this hotel room tonight.
I never sent you a note.
Rena, what is going on?
Grant, I swear, nothing is going on.
Nothing happened.
What do you mean nothing happened? What is this? What is this? What is this? What are you talking about? What are you trying to do?
Grant, listen to me.
Why didn't you simply tell me that you and Justin were having an affair?
Because I wasn't having an affair.
What do you call this? A friendly chat?
I was trying to get back at him.
Get back at him?
Yes.
You have one hell of a way of showing revenge.
You know how much I despise him.
Oh, that's another thing, lady. Oh, yeah, I really believe that. That's one hell of an act you got there, lady. I really believe...
Grant, this isn't an act. I love you. Please listen to me.
I've had enough.
I want you to tell the truth. I want you to tell the truth.
Rita, I don't believe that you even know what truth is.
Grant.
Where do you want me to put this, ma'am?
What?
It's the dinner your husband ordered.
Just take it out.
Keep them. Close.
Where are we?
If I told you, come on. You'd be surprised. Now, just...
Can I open my eyes now?
No, just a minute.
Gosh, you're patient.
Okay.
Now.
Where are we?
You light, my dear?
Oh, Mark. Oh, I love it. Is this yours?
Well, it better be, or else we're going to get caught for breaking and entering.
Well, I've had enough of jail. Thank you very much.
Oh, by the way, I'm taking care of that for you.
Oh, Mark, this is great.
Yeah, I'm glad you like it. Oh. Look, why don't you make yourself at home? I have to call my answering service and
can
get
I go
my
check
messages.
Out the other rooms?
Yeah. Be my guest.
Oh, it's fantastic.
Yeah, this is Mark Wheeler calling. Do you have any messages? Mm-hmm. He did. When? Oh, that's great news. Yeah, thanks. Look, why don't you take down this number in case you want to get in touch with me. 555-2422. Yeah, thanks again. Bye.
That is an amazing view you've got there.
Are you ready for this?
What?
That was the DA's office. You and Lurleen are in the clear.
Oh, Mark!
No, thank you very much. No message.
No answer. Now, do you believe me?
I don't know what to believe anymore.
You can believe that Rena is in Dallas with Justin Marshall. And that's where your father's going to find her.
If Rena and Justin are in that hotel room, how could you send Dad into that?
Isn't it obvious, Brett? Isn't it better that he find out about Rena now?
The only thing that's obvious is that you want to hurt him very badly because that's what's going to happen and you know it.
Sometimes we have to be cruel to be kind.
Oh, spare me the proverbs, Mom.
Brett, in this case, it happens to apply.
The only person you're worried about being kind to is yourself.
You think I was being kind to myself? Brett, that was a very difficult decision to make, to forge that note and then send it.
Please.
Brett, all right. Maybe I did want to hurt your father.
Why? Why do you want to hurt him?
Don't you think he's hurt me, too? Do you want to know how many times, how many ways?
No, I don't.
Brett, life hurts, and it's about time you found that out.
Stop it. Just stop it. I don't want to hear any more of this.
Well, you're going to have to. Oh, Brett. I'm sorry. This is not a time for us to be trading blame. Don't you understand? I love your father.
Well, if that's love, I hate it. I hate all of it. I can't stand what you do to each other.
Oh, darling, I'm sorry. Please, You're going to have to try to understand
this. I don't understand you. I don't think I'm ever going to understand you.
Brett!
Hey, Lurline, did a butterfly get in here?
Well, I don't think so. Why?
Because there's something that keeps flitting around in here.
Oh, well, maybe it's me.
Yeah, I thought it was kind of big for a butterfly. Why are you flitting?
I'm just trying to keep busy.
Nervous.
What makes you say that?
Whenever you get like this, it's because you got something on your mind. Mm-hmm. And come over here and light next to me and tell me what it is.
John, you don't want to hear my troubles.
Well, sure I do. It'll help me keep my mind off my own.
Are you ever serious?
Yeah. Yeah, I am right now. Now, come on. Tell me what's going on.
Joel, it's just this whole mess with Ruby and me getting arrested.
But Mark's going to take care of all that, you know.
I know he's going to try, but what if he can't? Joel, I've never felt more humiliated in my life when they locked me up like that.
Arlene, don't you worry about that. If they were to try to come and get you again, they'd have to take me first, darling.
Joel, I wouldn't want that.
Well, it wouldn't matter what you wanted or anybody else wanted. I've decided about this. I am not ever going to let anything like that happen to you again.
I wonder who that is.
Well, there'd be one way of finding out. That'd be to go to the door.
What if it's the police?
Arlene, it is not the police. Now flutter over to the door and see who it is, okay?
Who is it?
Hey, man.
Oh, hi. What can I do for you?
Well, I have a special delivery letter for Miss Lurleen Hopper.
That's me.
Just sign right here.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Well, what you got?
It's a letter from my Aunt Mavis.
You mean we're out of trouble?
That's what the message said.
Oh, You are so wonderful. How did you do this?
Well, I just sat the DA down and told him to listen to the facts. I knew once he followed him up, he'd find out that there was no way you and Lurleen could have been involved in Bo's death.
Oh, Lurleen is just going to flip when I tell her this. I can't
hey,
wait
come
to
come on, now, hold on. Wait a minute. There's something I want to do.
Okay.
Well, you just wait. Matter of fact, why don't you go enjoy that beautiful view on the terrace, okay?
What is this, some kind of dream?
No,
where did that music come from?
Oh, it's a quadraphonic sound. This place has everything.
I love it. Just like one of those old movies, you know, you get to this romantic scene and all of a sudden all this beautiful music just comes floating in. Ooh, champagne.
To your good news.
And to your beautiful new apartment. So how come you didn't tell me you were getting a new place?
Well, come on. Things were a little hectic, you know? Besides, I decided I want to make a surprise.
Mark, you mean you got this for me? So we could be together more and see each other more?
You remember that night at the coop? The closed place now?
Never forget it.
You said you wanted our first night to be a, how you say, special occasion?
Yeah.
Romantic trapping, the right setting, huh?
So?
So? What do you think?
It's perfect. Penthouse apartment and music, champagne. I feel like I'm in the movies.
This is no movie, my dear. this is real.
Don't answer.
Come on. What if it's important?
Call back.
Come on, babe, I have to. I'll make it brief, okay? Hello? What? When? Number 43? Who else is there? I'll be down there as soon as I can.
That was brief, all right. I got a feeling so's my visit.
Some problem in the oil fields.
And you gotta go.
Yes, I do.
That's okay. As long as it's just an oil field, it's my competition. I think I can handle it.
Well, good. Do I get a rain check?
Of course you do.
The other times. Come on. I'll drop you off on my way over there.
The role of Alison Linden is now being played by Terry Gauber.
Wish you didn't have to go.
Well, I had a great time, and you know, TJ and Paige are really nice.
Yeah, she's my aunt, and he's my uncle.
Oh, it makes me feel so good to see you this happy.
Well, there are two things that could make me even more happy.
You mean if Jester were here?
Well, that's one.
Well, what's the other?
You agreeing and moving in with us again?
Oh, you know you are such a little nag sometimes.
But I want you to come back and live with us.
Well, you know why I'm living where I'm living. But that doesn't mean that I can't hang around here a lot. Would that be okay?
That'd be great.
I'd like that a lot, too. Well, thank I'll be you around. For coming. I know. Sure. Well, I'll be seeing you all, and if I don't leave now, I will never get out of here.
Thanks for the gift certificate.
Don't you eat it all at once now.
Don't you worry, I won't let him. Good night. Be careful.
Oh, what's next?
This is. I have been all too nice to you the whole time, you know it? You're not going to get up out of this. Come on. What are you, what's wrong with you? You throwing in the towel already?
No, I thought I'd let you just win.
Yeah, I know somebody who's a sleepyhead. I saw that. Yard.
Not me.
Oh,
not
yes. Me. Time for you to go to bed.
Well, can't I just stay up a little longer, please? I don't want it to end so soon.
You just snuggle up here with me, okay?
You miss Marshall just as much as I do, don't you?
Yeah. Yeah, I sure do. I sure do.
Ooh, watch me really tickle their noses.
Tickle their noses with blueberries.
Blueberry muffins from Duncan Hines, so you know they're moist.
Tickle their noses with blueberries.
They taste just as great as they smell. Because Duncan Hines fills them with their sweetest, tastiest...
Brett!
Hi.
Are you okay?
Oh, Rick.
Brett, what's wrong?
Long story.
Let's start from the beginning.
All right. This afternoon, I went into my dad's office on my way home from work. And he had a note there from Rena asking him to meet her in a hotel in Dallas. And he decided to go.
Well, Brett, I thought you were all in favor of your father's relationship with Rena.
I am. The problem is that Rena didn't write the note.
Who did?
My mother.
Wait a minute. I thought you said your mother was trying to get your father back.
Oh, she is.
Well, then why would she go sending him off into Rena's arms?
That's just the point, Ricky. When my father gets to that hotel, it's very likely he's going to find Rena in the arms of Justin Marshall.
You got a letter from your Aunt Mavis?
Well, that's what it says here.
Who is Aunt Mavis?
She's my aunt. She lives in Oskaloosa, Iowa.
You're making all this up. I never heard of that either.
It's a very small little town. Well, she moved there right after she got married. I haven't seen her for years. Not since Uncle Vern's funeral in 72.
Well, I kind of get the impression that you like this little lady.
Oh, she's so nice. She wanted to take care of me right after my granddaddy died, but I wouldn't let her. She doesn't have very much money.
That's pretty generous of her, really.
That's the way she is. She just goes around giving what little she has to anybody and everybody.
Well, what about her family?
I'm it. She and Uncle Vern never had any children.
I guess she's pretty lonely, huh?
No, not really. I don't know how she keeps going sometimes. What with her tap dancing school for kids and her volunteer work at the hospital and the woman's club she presides over. I mean, she belongs to just about everything.
Well, I wonder what she said in her letter.
Oh! Oh, I guess I better open it and find out, huh?
Uh-huh. Well?
Oh, what?
Is it bad news?
No. It's good news. She's gonna be paying us, paying me a visit.
Ashley?
Oh, Marshall, you came back from my party.
Yeah, well, hey, I couldn't stay away. Oh, look at you. You got your racing helmet on.
You wouldn't take it off all night.
Oh.
It's the swellest gift.
Well, you're not going to sleep in that, are you?
Oh, I guess not. I'll take it off when I go to bed.
Yeah, and it's time for you to go to bed right now. Yeah.
But I want to show Marshall all my presents, Will.
Well, all right. Let me see him.
Certificate?
Oh, look at there. It's all that ice cream. $10.
And Aunt Paige gave me this, and Uncle TJ gave me this.
Uncle TJ?
Well, I know he isn't yet, but he will be soon.
Well, we'll talk about that when the time comes, all right? I think maybe you better do what Ashley says. I think it's time for you to go to bed, huh?
But you just got home.
Well, now, I think you should go to sleep. I'll tell you what. We'll make a deal. Tomorrow, we'll have our own little party, all right?
Okay. I even saved you some hot dogs.
Very thoughtful of you, son.
I think that, you better go on to bed now, okay?
Yeah.
Tell us good night.
Good night, Mom.
Good night, son. Let's have it.
What?
Don't be innocent with me.
What are you talking about?
Are you going to deny that you and TJ were lovers once?
Bird's Eye proudly introduces Dover Farms, the topping that tastes too good to stop. With one flop.
My dad can stop.
New Dover Farms frozen whipped topping is the only frozen topping whipped with real cream. Mm. That makes it too good to stop. With one plop.
Dad!
New Dover Farms from Bird's Eye. Real cream makes it taste too good to stop with one plop.
How embarrassed.
What's the exclusive story behind Bo and Luke quitting the Dukes of Hazzard? And what's the surprising truth about their unusual love lives? Inquiring minds want to know.
I want to know.
Why do insiders feel Robert Wagner will marry Jill St. John? This week's National Enquirer tells you. How can your family avoid fights over money?
This is in the Enquirer.
And why are space aliens giving Earth people messages? Find out in the Enquirer. Over 100 features for people with inquiring minds.
Like me. There's a sound a cat makes when she's really happy and healthy. And there's a way a cat looks when she's really happy and healthy. To keep your cats looking good and sounding good, feed them Calcan. Calcan's got all the vitamins and minerals and protein a cat needs.
It's so nutritious. It's like getting a multivitamin in every can.
Now that's the sound of a healthy cat.
Calcan. It's like getting a multivitamin in every can.
Stay tuned for the next part of Texas.
Tonight on NBC Nightly News, we'll have late reports from Beirut and Tel Aviv on the most serious fighting in the Middle East since the 73 war. Mother, how'd you like to feed your family meats poultry, fish, frozen foods, name brand staples, save on weekly food bills, plus save 36 to 42% on household quality food order specials like Maxwell House Coffee. At a something about rising food costs, dial 537-0242. Household quality foods, call right now for full details on how your family can eat better for much less. That's now the next part of Texas.
What are you talking about? TJ and I are not lovers.
You were engaged, weren't you?
Who told you that?
What does it matter who told me that?
It was Rena, wasn't it?
Forget about Rena.
It had to be her.
Why? Lots of people know about it, don't they?
No, not a lot of people.
That's the point. I didn't even know about it. When I asked you about you and TJ's relationship, you said you were just college friends. Friends.
I didn't see the point in trying to drag up the past, Justin.
So you thought you'd hide it from me. Why?
Because I thought that you'd react exactly the way that you're reacting
now.
You
know, I never did trust TJ, but you were always standing up for him. Now I know why.
No, you don't know anything.
Yeah, I know. I'm going to make TJ pay for this, and that's for sure.
Just stop and listen to me a minute.
Why, listen to some more lies?
I am not lying about anything.
Like the time you told me you were pregnant and you weren't. It seems this is a real pattern with you, isn't it?
You know that was different.
Different? Oh, yeah, different. Oh, that's some big excuse. I am fed up.
Now, Justin, where are you going?
I'm going to settle a score.
What, you're going to go find TJ?
I'm going to tear him apart.
Justin, don't do this.
You can't protect him anymore.
Now, Justin, I'm me. Come on, TJ, answer the phone. Oh, well, Mark got called off on some emergency or something, but honey, I got the best news.
About you and Mark?
No, about you and me. We are free and clear.
Free and clear?
With the law, Mark got us off.
Oh, that, how'd he do that?
Well, he just pulled a few strings with the DA and that was that.
Well, that's good, Ruby. That was real nice of him.
Oh, Lurleen, he is just getting better and better. Oh, and you should see his new apartment.
He got a place of his own?
For me, Lurleen, so that we can be together. And it's so beautiful. It's the most expensive, extravagant place I've ever seen in my entire life. I'm just going to love spending time there.
That's good.
Honey, what is wrong with you?
What?
Well, I can understand you not getting real excited about Mark's penthouse, but I thought you'd be jumping for joy that we got off with the law.
Oh, well, I am, Ruby. I'm really relieved.
Well, you're not acting it. What is that?
What? Oh.
What's this letter?
No, it's nothing.
Well, it's from your Aunt Mavis. Now, what did she want?
Ruby, she saw my picture in the paper with Mr. and Mrs. Wheeler, and she thinks I'm part of Houston society.
Well, you practically are. I mean, look at all the high-class people you've been gallivanting around with.
But it's not true.
Well, it's not going to hurt your Aunt Mavis to think it is.
It is when she finds out the truth.
Honey, how in the world is she ever going to find out?
When she gets off the bus from Oskaloosa in a few days.
She's coming here?
That's what the letter's all about.
Oh. Oh. Gosh, you really are in a bind.
Ruby, you don't have to remind me of that. What am I going to do?
Well, Lurleen, why don't you just write her a letter and tell her the truth?
I can't do that.
Why not?
Because then she'll start worrying about me and she'll start sending me things I can't afford. Not only that, it's really going to embarrass her.
Well, why? It seems like it's a much more embarrassing situation for you than it is for her.
Ruby, Aunt Mavis is the president of the Oskaloosa Parliamentary Law and Literary Club, and she wants to do the July program on me.
Well, we just got to come up with some way to keep her from coming.
How?
I don't know. Let me think.
Ruby, there's just not a way out of this.
I mean, if we try to talk her out of not coming, she's just going to get suspicious.
I've got an idea. What if you tell her that you're gallivanting on the French Riviera?
It's not going to stop her from coming another time.
You're right. Okay, okay. I got to come up with a plan here.
Ruby.
What, honey?
I told her things.
What things?
Well, I just exaggerated a little, you know, because she was so worried about me after my granddaddy died that I just kind of painted a picture that was exaggerated so she wouldn't worry about me.
What did you tell her?
Well, the Coupe isn't exactly the fancy club that I own, and this isn't exactly the penthouse that I'm supposed to live in.
I see.
Just when one mess is over, another one starts.
Oh, honey, don't start fretting now. I got you out of all our other troubles, didn't I?
Eventually.
Well, I'm going to get you out of this, too. You just wait. I'll think of something. I always do.
Judith, I just got to get into Rena's office and get that sample of her handwriting.
You're sure that's not going to be a problem?
No problem. I can just go in there because I always go to see Mark.
Well, once we have the sample, we're going to have to practice to get her handwriting down.
I think we can do that.
And then there's one thing more.
What's that?
Do you have a pen and some paper?
Oh, sure. Just a minute.
I think it's about time that we composed Rena's little love note to my husband. Hello, Grant. I wasn't sure you'd be home tonight. John told me you'd gone to Dallas. I made a pitcher of martinis for you. It's just the way you like it.
Thank you.
How was Dallas?
I don't want to talk about it.
Sounds to me like you didn't enjoy yourself.
Would that please you?
Grant, I...
Judith. I had a terrible time in Dallas, so let's just... drop it.
I can't drop it, Grant. There's something I have to tell you.
Playtex Living Gloves, and we had some day.
With spot removed, scrubbed and shined, scoured pots, and turpentine, are we worn out? This new layer of neoprene makes us stronger to last longer, with better protection against certain household solvents and chemicals. With a tough pair like us on hand, there's so much you can do, and stay beautiful, too. Thanks.
New improved Playtex Living Gloves, now made stronger to last longer.
Airwick presents some smelly reasons why you need a rug and room deodorizer.
Clover who's all over. The old hoagie stogie. The damp, musty.
Once these odors get trapped in your rug, they're in your room. So you need Airwick Carpet Fresh. Just sprinkle Carpet Fresh powder on, wait a few minutes, and vacuum. It overcomes the source of odors in your carpet. Your room has a fresh, clean smell. Carpet Fresh. America's number one rug and room deodorizer.
The summer sizzles on NBC, sizzles with romance on Days of Our Lives.
You are the woman that I love.
Marlena and Roman's love heats up under the Mexican sun.
Thank you for being the nicest man that I have ever known.
I'm also the hardest. That's got nothing to do with the sun.
This week on Days of Our Lives.
Brett, where would your mother come up with the idea that Rena was going to be with Justin?
Apparently, she heard somewhere about a bet between Rena and Justin.
What kind of a bet?
I don't know any of the details. But the long and the short of it is that if Rena lost the bet, she agreed to go to bed with Justin.
What? That's crazy.
I know. Listen, I didn't want to believe it either. So I called the hotel in Dallas and I asked for Rena's room and she wasn't registered. And then I asked for Justin Marshall's room and he was registered. Mr. and Mrs. Justin Marshall were registered.
Yeah, well, how do you know that didn't mean Ashley?
Because I ran into Paige today and she said that she was off to a party at Ashley's tonight.
Man, there's something wrong here. Look, Rena would never agree to a bet like that.
Ricky, look, my mother has no reason to lie.
Yeah, but this is crazy. Rena can't stand Justin Marshall. There's been bad blood between those two for years.
I know. I thought so, too. Listen, I've been pushing the two of them together, my dad and Rena, for months now. I really thought she was going to be good for him.
Well, I think she will be good for him. Look, Brett, I know Rena really well, and I don't think Rena would do something like this.
Then what is the explanation?
I don't know. Hey, come on, babe. Look, everything's gonna be all right.
No, it's not. It's not gonna be all right. And I'm never gonna understand this. What happens to love? Doesn't it last?
I thought I heard somebody prowling around in here.
I was just having myself a little snack.
Don't tell me. A peanut butter sandwich and corn chips on the side.
Well, how'd you know?
Getting a pretty educated little sniffer here.
You better watch out. They're going to rinse you out for bloodhound.
Hey, is Lurleen asleep?
Yeah, finally. I think she wore herself out pacing.
I know. She was nervous all night. I thought at first it was about the jail, you know.
Oh, no. Thank God that is over.
Amen. What else could it be?
She didn't tell you?
No, she's been kind of quiet with me. Is it something I did?
Oh, no, Joel. Lurleen would never get mad at you for something you did.
Well, then what is it?
It's this special delivery letter she got.
The one from Aunt Mavis?
Yeah.
No, I was with her when she got that. That was good news.
Well, it's good news and bad news. I guess Aunt Mavis is coming here for a visit, which Lurleen is really happy about, but there's a problem.
What?
Well, I guess Lurleen painted a slightly rosier picture of life around here than it really is. She did it for her aunt's sake, you know, so she wouldn't worry about her after her granddaddy passed on.
Oh, that sounds just like her looking after somebody else. I mean, because I know she'd never deliberately set out to deceive anybody.
Oh, no, but she's kind of in a bind now because Aunt Mavis thinks Lurleen is part of Houston's high society or something. So once she gets a look at our little honky-tonk, she's going to be pretty upset.
I wish there was something I could do to help her.
Oh, me too. I've been sitting here racking my brain.
You come up with anything?
Not yet, but I'm still working on it. I'll think of something.
Okay.
Wait a minute.
Hurry up.
Keep ringing. Hello? Too late.
Oh, well, maybe they'll call back.
Yeah, honey, you know, I think I'm going to call the desk and see if somebody left a message. Mm. And sweetheart, in the meantime, would you make me a drink? Cold drink?
A little walk wear you out, did it?
You mean our little hike?
Hey, now, come on. It was a beautiful evening. You know you enjoyed it.
Yes, I did. It was lovely. Oh, yes, hello. This is Paige Marshall. Are there any messages for me? Ashley Marshall? Okay. Anything else? All right, thank you very much. Ashley.
I wonder what Ashley wanted.
I don't know. Let me give her a call.
Yeah.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. And, oh, sweetheart, would you get that?
Sure.
Well,
Oh, hey, Justin, how...
After a tough practice, you probably think I use a deodorant soap. No way. I made a break from deodorant soaps a long time ago. A clean break with Ivory.
Wow.
Look inside. Ivory's a basic natural soap to give you an honest clean. And there's no way you can be cleaner than that. You see, Ivory doesn't mix up clean with a bunch of additives like heavy perfumes and deodorants. Those things don't get you clean. And I always use a deodorant after I shower, so I don't want one in my soap. Ivory's made to do just one thing, get me as clean as I can be. So I feel clean, I smell clean. That's an honest clean.
Take a clean break. With Ivory, no soap can get you cleaner than that, no matter how hard you try.
Hi, Mama.
Hi, did you get everything?
Yeah.
We used to buy a lot of what we thought were bargains. Well, this they like.
This they didn't.
This they like.
Yeah, great.
This they didn't. What good's a bargain they don't like?
Take toilet tissue. We're back to Charmin because it has all that squeezable softness we bargained for.
And we like the convenience of this six-pack.
Oh, we tried no-name toilet tissue.
Not soft enough.
Look, they both have the same number of sheets. No name, Charmin. See how much thicker and fluffier Charmin is? This softness they'll like.
And this softness we're gonna keep. Charmin in a convenient six-pack.
A bargain they'll like.
T.J., are you all right?
No, no, stop, T.J., don't. Stop it, you. Justin, what are you doing?
T.J. can tell you all about it.
What?
No, I'm afraid that you stumped me on this one, Justin. Cut the act, T.J. You're probably gonna say you don't remember being engaged to my wife, either.
Oh, is that what this is all about?
Oh, well, maybe it doesn't mean anything to you. I don't like to be kept in the dark.
There's no reason for you to know.
Why? Is it still going on?
What?
You and Ashley were lovers, don't you remember? Feelings like that die kind of hard. You still love her?
Come on, Justin.
You stay away from him.
Justin.
I don't want you seeing him anymore.
Justin, stop!
I mean
what
it.
What are you doing?
As of now, you are out of my sister's life.
Get out.
If you start anything, Justin, if you start it, I'll finish it.
You.
T.J., go, please.
What?
You've got to get out of here. Please,
I'll kill you.
Go. Please go. Please.
Need you here with this maniac?
I'll be all right. I just have to talk to him.
And I'll call you.
You better not try. And another thing. Forget about coming into work. You're fired. Your stuff will be packed up and shipped to you.
Justin.
I've got just one thing to say to you, Justin. You can take a job and shove it.
Oh!
So long.
How are you, darling? Big brother?
Nice boyfriend you got there.
You were asking for it. You know.
You knew about this all along?
About the engagement, yes. All right. I knew about it.
Didn't bother you?
Justin, it happened a long time ago.
Oh. That man has got you. He's got you more fooled than I realized.
You're the only fool here.
I'm just trying to save you some pain.
Oh, how? By keeping me from the man I love?
Paige, he's trying to hurt you. I know that. It's never crossed your mind about he and Ashley
Justin,
working together. Maybe they work
just
together.
Stop it!
Kind of gets to you, doesn't it?
I don't want to talk anymore about this.
I'll tell you, Paige, he's bad for you. You stay away from him.
Do you have something to tell me?
Yes. The note that you got from Rena.
What about that?
I forged it.
You what?
I had to.
What kind of an answer is that?
I was only trying to protect you.
Protect me?
Yes, protect you from that woman. She was just trying to use you.
Oh, Judith, I don't believe this.
You did find Rena with Justin Marshall in that hotel room, didn't you?
You forged that note? How did you know about Justin and Rena in the first place?
That's not important. What does matter is that you found out.
Oh, yeah. I certainly did.
If I just told you that they were going to be together in Dallas, would you have believed me?
Probably not. I just figured it was another one of your lies.
Yes, I know you don't trust me. But don't you see why I had to do it? I love you, Grant. I had to protect you and make sure that you wouldn't make a terrible mistake with that woman.
You love me? Did you figure that by putting her out of the picture that you and I would get back together again?
I just wanted to expose Rena. I wasn't thinking about us.
You weren't. Did you really believe that I'd come running back to you?
You know I'll always be here for you, don't you?
You're sadly mistaken, you.
Maybe I am, but now you know what it feels like to hurt, too. And you found out about Rena.
Yeah. I now know what it's like to hurt. If that was your intention.
I didn't intend to hurt you, but it happens. Don't you see, I...
Texas will be right back.
Hey, Duncan, at the Nabisco Baker's Picnic.
Do it again.
We bake a
wheat thin thinner. You have to really hit the word thinner. That's important because the thinner the wheat thins, the better the taste. Keep practicing and I'll just keep eating wheat thins one after the other.
We bake a wheat thin thinner. You get a better taste.
Yes!
Wheat Thins crackers. The thinner the wheat thins, the better the taste. From Nabisco.
Presenting the Sears All-Star Father's Day Sale. A surefire winner, the Dragon Emblem shirt in assorted colors. Only $8.99. Save $5. Comfort for dad's every move. All stretch jeans and flex lacks 25% off. Another hit, Sears Classic Collection. Solid color and pinstripe tailored separates. Now 25% savings. For an all-star lineup. For an all-star father.
You can count on Sears.
With today's inflation, what can you feed a child besides soup or a sandwich? I serve delicious hot meals with meat from Chef Boyardee.
They're even bite-sized. For me.
Mini ravioli are little pies in tangy sauce stuffed with meat. Delicious. And mini bites are... delicious little pie stuffed with cheese with lots of little meatballs. And the taste? Great.
Chef Boyardee, mini bites and mini ravioli. Delicious kid-sized meals with meat.
Sleeping out here, huh?
Oh, I was waiting up for you.
You were you?
Where'd you get that?
Oh, this is just an accident.
Did TJ give it to you?
Oh, what makes you think that?
Well, I heard you fighting with Ashley about TJ. I don't think I like him very much.
Well, don't worry about that. You're not going to see much of him anymore. None of us will.
Marshall?
What's that?
Now that I'm your son, legally and everything, could I change my last name? I mean, could I be Gregory Marshall?
we here?
A mismatch, Minnie. Look what I found when we moved this monster. See this tile where the table was?
Yeah.
That's the color my floor's supposed to be. Now, the rest of the floor looks dingy.
That's because you've got grand and dirt stuck in these little crevices.
Dirt's what makes the color, though.
Don't say I need a new floor.
I say you need spick and span.
Look, ground in dirt can dull your whole floor in its true color. But spick and span cleans deep into crevices and lifts out ground in dirt.
But is it safe for no wax floors, too?
When will this generation learn? No floor cleaner's safer than spick and span.
I'm a believer, Minnie.
Don't believe me. Believe the results you see. Spick and span helps your floor show its true color.
Introducing a stand-out white.
A new Oxydol white.
Now, Oxydol with built-in bleach is improved for whiter whites.
This shirt got really dirty the day I took Jeff to the playground. I was afraid it was ruined. Good thing I had new Oxydol. It's improved for whiter whites. But could new Oxydol turn my shirt into a standout white?
New Oxydol will. It's improved for whiter whites. Watch. A dirty white shirt washed in new Oxydol gets so white, it actually compares to a new white shirt.
New Oxydol turned my dirty shirt into a standout white.
Get new Oxydol. It's improved for a standout white.
A new Oxydol white.
This part of Texas was brought to you by Oxydol. Oxydol bleaches as it washes. For white so white, they'll actually compare to new.
Each weekday at this time for the continuing story of Texas, the new generation.
Tuesday, you're a friend of Billy the Kid?
When Maverick harbors a wounded criminal, he takes on the press and the law.
Hit Maverick!
No need to shout.
Then on Flamingo Road, for the passion, for the power, for the game. Flamingo Road, Tuesday following Maverick on NBC.
The Israeli-Palestinian fighting intensifies, and the British use an unusual ploy in the Falklands. The president addresses the British Parliament, and a novel way to increase voter participation in California. We'll have all those stories and more coming up on 13 Strong News.
If you have a damp, dark, unpleasant basement that gets even wetter during rainy weather, call and talk to Colonial Builders about restoring your basement to a bright and cheerful place to be. The hydrochannel method has been perfected by Colonial Builders during 14 years of basement waterproofing experience. All work is guaranteed, so call Colonial for an estimate at your house. Restore your basement to a bright, dry, and cheerful place to be. The cost is surprisingly low. You've tried the rest, now call the best. Call Colonial Builders today.
It's our summer clearance sale from At Last in the Starlight Plaza. Save up to 50% on all summer clothing for big, beautiful women from the At Last shop in the Starlight Plaza.
You're viewing WTVG Toledo. This is 13 Strong News.
Brought to you in part by First Federal Savings and Loan of Toledo, with 14 convenient locations, the saving place.
Good afternoon. Israeli warplanes shot down four Syrian MiG jets today, two of them over Israel and two north of Beirut, Lebanon. On the ground, the Israeli...
On down. For a great vacation, just say the word.
TV.
Look, Rena, I don't want to start any trouble.
Then why were you going to my door?
I told you I was looking for something to read.
I don't believe that for a minute.
You know, Rena, I don't think you're up to the pressures of being about to. You're starting to get paranoid.
Paranoid? I'm very impressed, Ruby. I didn't think a little tramp like you would know the meaning of such a big word.
I know the meaning of lots of words, Rena, and most of them aren't half so polite as paranoid.
That's more like it, Ruby. Come on, give me the gutter language. It's about time you showed your color.
Get out of my way!
Not until you tell me what you were doing on my desk.
All right. If you really want to know what I was doing in your desk, I'll tell you. I was looking for evidence to link you with Mr. Hannibal. I think you know a whole lot more about his business dealings than you let on.
That's ridiculous.
I don't think so. You're pretty hung up on your boss, aren't you?